Más antes teníamos de esos animalitos en el pozo. En mi familia hubimos 4 personas con chikungunya, pues gracias a Dios, con la prevención que vinieron a Colonia Monteverde, pues hay pocas enfermedades.
Ya no hay zancudos y se evitan muchas enfermedades.
Me siento feliz.
Our story begins with this mosquito, which is one of the most serious health threats on the planet. It is responsible for Zika, dengue fever, chikungunya, and yellow fever. We all know about Zika, the disease that causes microcephaly in babies. Dengue is even more deadly, with 100 million cases worldwide each year, 500,000 children hospitalized annually because of life-threatening complications, and 20,000 fatalities. There are no vaccines in use against Zika, dengue, or chikungunya, so the only way to combat these diseases is to go after the mosquito. Unfortunately, there has been little progress despite billions of dollars spent worldwide each year on pesticides against just this one species. In fact, it's been getting worse, and with global climate change, these diseases threaten to spread from the tropics into North America and Europe. Fortunately, there's another way. It's biological control, which uses natural enemies of mosquito larvae to eliminate mosquito production. The strength of biological control comes from mobilizing nature to do the work. It's effective, environmentally friendly, and sustainable. And it costs almost nothing beyond showing people how to do it. Did you know that a baby turtle can eat 1,000 mosquito larvae a day? Is it possible to use turtles and other predators of mosquito larvae to protect a community from Zika, dengue, and other diseases? The pioneering success of Monteverde has shown that the answer is yes. This humble community near San Pedro Sula, Honduras, used biological control to wipe out mosquito production and free itself from mosquito-borne diseases. Like many poor and neglected communities in Latin America, Monteverde's 350 homes and 1,400 residents do not have a proper water supply. They have bottled water for drinking, but the water for all their other needs, including bathing and cleaning, comes out of the faucet for only about an hour each week, so families have to store water in a variety of containers. The most common containers are cement tanks, plastic drums, and buckets. And these water storage containers, along with household wells, are exactly where the mosquitoes breed. For years, dengue fever was a regular part of life in Monteverde. Zika and chikungunya also swept through Monteverde in 2016. And with Zika came the heartbreak of a baby, born with microcephaly. That's when a non-profit organization, Operation Blessing Honduras, told the people of Monteverde about biological control and offered to help them get started with it. Biological control can be as straightforward as introducing a baby turtle into one of these water storage tanks. The turtles cost about $1. And are so effective that no mosquito larvae survive in a tank with a turtle. No mosquito larvae, no mosquito production. Families adopt the turtles as pets and feed them with a bit of tortilla and cabbage. Every turtle continues doing its job for years, making that $1 investment pay for itself many times over. And Monteverde's biological control toolkit has more than just turtles. These tiny shrimp-like animals, known as copepods, are like great white sharks to mosquito larvae. When a few copepods are introduced to a household well that has been producing mosquitoes, the copepods quickly multiply into thousands of hungry mouths that devour every mosquito larva, and continue to do so for as long as there is water in the well. The people of Monteverde were able to use native copepods that they found living in a small marsh, only a few hundred yards away. it was easy to produce large numbers of copepods to provide them free to every household in the community. Tilapia are another predator in Monteverde's biological control toolkit. These fish are readily available from a government fish hatchery, and baby tilapia cost less than a penny a piece. They thrive in wells and water storage containers, and eat every mosquito larva in sight. It took more than a year of hard work and experimentation with dead corals, copepods, and fish for the people of Monteverde to work out the details of how to use them and craft the biological control into a lasting solution. The key to success was community volunteers, mainly local housewives and mothers, who were leading the effort by working with their neighbors to encourage everyone to do what was necessary. The volunteers have continued to visit every home at least once a month to make sure everything is going okay. Before starting the biological control, a survey counted 43,000 mosquito larvae in Monteverde. Once the biological control was solidly in place, monthly surveys documented how the mosquito larvae and the mosquitoes declined month after month. Until now, there is no mosquito production at all. To our knowledge, this is the first time that this kind of success has been recorded anywhere in Latin America during recent decades. Most important, Monteverde has been completely free of Zika, dengue, and chikungunya since the beginning of 2017.
Toda como comunidad nos sentimos aquí alegres por los logros que hemos tenido hasta ahora.
Nosotros nos sentimos felices y orgullosos de tener una colonia limpia, libre más que todo de los zancudos.
Monteverde's success is an inspiration for thousands of similar communities to do the same. We don't need to depend on high-cost solutions to get rid of these diseases at a local level, and it's not necessary to wait for government. Local communities can do it for themselves if they just receive some help to get started.
Hago, le ayudo a mi papá a hacer el monitoreo mensual. Bueno, y también ayudo en las trampas VG. En la de las larvas, recolectar larvas.
Sentiríamos felices de también llevar esta buena noticia a otras comunidades que no lo conocen.
The time has come to spread the word so biological control and its benefits can be offered to others. The pivotal role of the volunteers in Monteverde's story highlights the importance of developing a strong team of volunteers at each new location. Monteverde's volunteers started out as an ordinary residents of a mosquito-plagued community. Now they are citizen scientists and community educators with expertise in mosquito eradication by biological control. They can train volunteers in other communities and provide additional assistance for them to get up and running, starting with a few communities and expanding to hundreds or more. Monteverde can serve as a demonstration site. It can produce native copepods, turtles, and tilapia for other communities. And Monteverde can embark on new research and development to make the biological control even more effective. Now, we need your help so that Monteverde's citizens, scientists, and community educators can continue their work. Donate now to support these committed individuals so they can help other communities to free themselves from these diseases and set in motion a cascade of community empowerment to create healthier lives.
¿Cómo ayudarle a otras personas, las que todavía no conocen qué es la prevención del Zika y el chikungunya? Nosotros con mucho gusto.
You can see more about the Monteverde story at ecotippingpoints.org/Monteverde. You can make a donation at ecotippingpoints.org/mvdonate.